Hello students, now turn to the speech coding methods. The speech coding methods are broadly classified into two kinds of the coding methods. One is the lossy compression method and lossless compression method. In kind of the lossless coding, the speech signal is reconstructed at the end of the coder, can have exactly the same as the input speech signal, wherein in the lossy coding techniques have the reconstructed speech signal perceptually indistinguishable from the original speech signal. So in lossless compression method, at the decoder end, whatever the output is available, that is the shape of that output is exactly same with the shape of the input signal. But in lossy compression or coding technique, whatever the output generated at the decoder side, that is not exactly with the input side. So the some kind of the quality will get degraded. In lossy coding techniques, though the reconstructed speech signal waveforms differs from the original speech signal waveform, the majority of the speech coding techniques are based on the lossy coding techniques because it saves the memory or saves the storage space, as well as reduce the data bit rate and remove the information which is irrelevant from the perceptual quality of the point of view. The best example is nothing but the MP3 signal or MP4 signal, where you can compress the signal. Some kind of the quality may get reduced, but the perceptual quality maintained as it is. The modern speech coding method is divided into the two types. One is the waveform coding and second one is the parametric coding method. The classification of the speech coders can be classified depending upon its, or the classification of the speech coders depending upon its bit rate. So classification depending of the bit rate are the four types: high bit rate coder, medium bit rate coder, low bit rate coder, and very low bit rate coder. So if the high bit rate coder is used for the coding, its bit range greater than 15 kilobits per second. For the medium, it should be 5 to 15 kilobits per second. If it is low bit rate coder, so it should be 2 to 5 kilobits per second. Or very low bit rate coder, may be less than the 2 kilobits per second. So the classification by the coding. So based on the type of coding technique used, speech coders are classified into the three types. The waveform coders and parametric coders, and third one is the hybrid coders. In the waveform coders, digitize the speech signal on the sample by sample spaces. So the digitization can be done by the sample and sample by sample spaces basis. Its main goal is to make the output waveform resemble the input waveform. So as per the input, the output waveform will be resembled. So the waveform coder retain the good quality of the speech. So in this, the waveform coder will get good quality of the speech. The waveform coders are low complexity coders which produces high quality speech at the data rates above the 16 kilobits per second. So it uses the high quality coder. When the data rate is lowered below this value, the reconstructed speech signal gets degraded. So if the coder is below this rate, so the signal will get degraded. The waveform coder are not specific to the speech signal and can be used for any type of the signal. So two types of the waveform coders are time domain waveform coders and frequency domain waveform coders. The example for the time domain waveform coders is nothing but it is one kind of the digitization schemes, and sample by samples will get converted into the speech signal, digital speech signal. Some examples are the PCM, that is pulse code modulation, DPCM, differential pulse code modulation, ADPCM, that is adaptive differential pulse code modulation, and delta modulation. These are the some time domain waveform coders. Next one, frequency domain waveform coders are the speech. In the frequency domain waveform coder, the segment of the speech signal converted into the frequency band. and each band is coded separately using the waveform coders. In these coders, the accuracy of the encoding is altered dynamically between the bands to suit the requirements of the speech waveforms. The examples are the waveform coders, are the subband coders, and adaptive transform coders. Next one is the parametric coder. This is the second type of the coder. In parametric coder, the speech signal is assumed to be generated from a model controlled by the some speech parameters. In these coders, the speech signal is modulated by using the limited number of parameters corresponding to the speech production mechanism. So, referring the speech production mechanism, some parameters are used to generate the speech signal. These parameters are obtained by analyzing the speech signal before transmission. At the receiving end, the decoder uses this parameter to reconstruct the original speech signal. In this coder, the output speech signal is not exact replica of the input signal. So, there may be some changes in the parameters of the signal. So, output speech signal is not exactly with the input speech signal. And the resemblance of the input speech signal is lost. So, shape of the input speech signal is lost here at the output of the decoder. However, the output speech signal will alter the same as the input speech signal. Using the parametric coder, it is possible to obtain the very low bit rates at the reasonable quality. So, here the very low bit rate coder can be used. To retain the quality of the waveform, the property of both speech coding mechanism can be used by increasing the bit rate and to the parametric code. So, at lower bit rate, the quality attained by the waveform coder is less compared to the parametric coder. The example of the parametric coder are the linear predictive coders and mixed excitation linear predictive coders. So LPC and MELP are the some examples of the parametric coders. This class of the coders works well for the low bit rate. In these coders, the increasing the bit rate does not result in an increasing the quality, as it is restricted by the coder. Next, the hybrid, that is the combination of the previous two. The hybrid coders try to fill the gap between the waveform coder and parametric coder. So, this is the combination of the waveform coder and parametric coder. Hybrid coders operates at minimum bit rates between those waveform coders and parametric coders and produce the high quality of the speech than the parametric one. So, in hybrid coder output, the quality of the output is well enough as per the or compared by to the parametric coder. These are the number of hybrid coding schemes which differs in the way the excitation parameters are generated. Some of these techniques quantize the reducible signal directly, while others substitute the approximated quantized waveform selected from the available set of the waveform. So the some examples are the hybrid coders are the code excited linear predictive codes, that is CELP coder. Next one is the this is the example of the predictive coder, that is linear predictive coding. In linear predictive coding, that is LPC is defined. This is the parametric coding example. Linear predictive coding LPC is defined as the method for the encoding the analog signal in which the value of current speech signal is estimated using the past few speech samples values of a speech signal. It was proposed by the federal standard, defense in the federal standards in 1984. Under the normal conditions, speech is sampled at the 8000 samples per second with 8 bit per sample, and this makes bit rate of 64,000 bits per sample second. Using the linear predictive coding, the bit rate is reduced to the 2400 bits per second. So this much amount of the bit rate can be reduced. At this reduced bit rate, there is a small amount of the loss of quality of the speech signal. So if the bit rate is reduced, the quality of the speech signal will get reduced. Hence, using the linear predictive coding, there is a loss in the quality of the speech signal, and hence it is considered as a lossy compression technique. So the bit rate is almost reduced to 2400 bits per second for 64 bits per second, from the 64 bits per second. So this linear predictive coding of parametric coding technique, this comes under the lossy compression technique. The next one is the speech production and modeling. The speech signals are considered composed of the sequence of the sound. These speech sounds are the transitions between some, serve as a symbolic representation of the information. The arrangement of these sounds is governed by the rules of the language, and the study of these rules and their implementation in the human communication is logistic. And the study and classification of the sounds of speech is called as a phonetics. So for this point, you can refer the human production system, human sound production system. So you can refer this point for this slide. So the LP continued on the LPC model. The source filter. So here the LPC model is given. So this is the mathematical representation of the LPC model. So the source filter model in the LPC is also known as a linear predictive coding model. It has two key components, LPC analysis, that is encoding, and LPC synthesizes, decoding. In LPC analysis, the speech signal is examined and it is segmented into the blocks, which we can call it as a frame. And each frame is examined to find the frame is voiced or unvoiced, the pitch of each frame, the parameter needed to build up the filter that models the vocal contract. The goal of LPC analysis is to estimate whether the speech signal is voiced or non-voiced, pitch of that frame, each frame, and it is needed to build the source filter model. These parameters are used for the tested of the speech signal and reconstruction of the source filter model. This parameter is transmitted to the receiver, and at the receiver will carry out the LPC synthesize. So at the receiver, they carry out the LPC synthesize using the received parameters and builds a sum filter model. And when provided a correct output, will accurately reconstruct the original signal. So in LPC, the output will be developed by testing the past samples or past frames. So by comparing the current frames is compared to the current output frame is compared with the previous frame, and the comparison is fed to the filter, and filter will get synthesize that signals and reproduce the signal which is exactly with the original one. So this is the mathematical model of the speech production. So this is the input, this is the white noise input train VB. This V plus UV, it is added with the some kind of the noise. So it is fed to the LPC filter. Now the speech signal is available. So this is the speech production system. In the LPC analysis, for each frame, the decision making process is made and calculate whether the frame is voiced or unvoiced. So decision making takes place about the frame. If frame is voiced, an input symbol is used to represent it with non-zero tags occurring at the interval of the pitch period. The method used for the estimation of the pitch period is the autocorrelation method. In some scheme the autocorrelation method is used, otherwise the different schemes are available. And if frame is not considered as unvoiced, the frame is represented using the white noise and the pitch period is zero. because it is unvoiced, so speech period is zero, as a vocal cord do not vibrant. So the excitation of the LPC filter is an impulse train or white noise, and it is important to emphasize that the parameter pitch, gain and filter coefficient will carry with time from one frame to the other. Thank you.